In this week's Fixture Friday, I'm gonna show you how to machine a thin plate with lots of holes in it on a customizable vacuum chuck. Let's get started. I was made for this. So in this week's Fixture Friday, we're gonna talk about vacuum chucking and specifically the use of a customizable top plate. Now, if you're not sure what this is, check out the card for our vacuum system overview along with our top plate overview. But in short, a customizable top plate allows you to create a gasket pattern that perfectly matches the shape of your part if the grid pattern doesn't do a good enough job. So in this case, we cut a customizable vacuum chuck to hold both the starting raw piece of material, come up with a finished piece of material, and the remnant piece. Let's take a closer look. So let me start with the raw piece of material. Now I cut a pocket for the part to sit in. It's about 50 thousandths deep. You can go a little bit deeper if you need to, but 50 thousandths is good enough to pick up an edge. Now when you put the part in, it perfectly locates. So that's the first thing I want to point out is you can locate your part stock repeatedly by putting it in a shallow pocket. The next thing is there's actually two separate vacuum work holding areas. The first would be this outer edge. And what I've done here is drilled four through holes and put shallow slots in between them just so that the air can more easily spread across that surface. If you don't have these shallow slots in place, there's a chance that your material, especially if it's a soft plastic, will self-gasket at the hole itself, and you'll lose vacuum pressure along the edges little by little. Now, the second vacuum work holding area would be where the actual part sits. Now, you'll notice that there's plenty of areas that break through this part. There's obviously the long slot here, this larger diameter hole, that one too, and then these small 440 drilled and tapped holes. Now, if we simply drill through or machine through without isolating those areas, we'll instantly lose vacuum pressure, probably crash, definitely crash and break a tool, and it's just not safe. So how do we get around this? Well, obviously you can't do this on a standard vacuum chuck. You have to use a top plate, but watch as I remove this and take a look at all the areas that break through and see how they're isolated from the rest of the areas. Now you see that? You see how I grouped together some of the holes that break through? Again, there's no need to gasket individual holes. Sections of holes are best. Now this part also has this odd little flange here. There's no way that you could get vacuum to be applied to this surface. So what do? We simply place that feature on the outside of the gasket. So the area in between the remnant piece of the material and the finished piece of material is the area that has all the features that are exposed to the atmosphere. So air is held inside here and inside here, but not in these pockets or areas where the end mill cuts the perimeter. So it looks complex, but in reality, it's really quite simple. Two separate gasket areas, avoiding areas that break through so we don't lose vacuum pressure. So if you want to learn more about our vacuum chucks, check out the cards at the end of this video, or check our description for a link where you can see all the overview videos about our systems. If you like this type of content, we're always gonna be making Fixture Friday series. So subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you can be one of the first to comment and we see it, get inspired, make more videos. So until next time, go innovate your production.